So you got a PS4 controller and Naruto Shippudden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 and camp.
Okay, so this video, I recorded this video a couple of years ago, and I noticed that there's a lot of people asking me multiple times different other things about how to set this up, how to make it work, and help you in 2020 how to actually get your PS4 controller working on your computer to be able to play either Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 or any other game as if it was an Xbox 360 controller. So if you find any of my tutorials helpful, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel and make sure to press on the notification bell so that every single time I release a new video, you'll be notified. On a side note, I stream on Twitch every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So if you just want to go ahead and hang out or ask me any other question, you can check the link in the description below to meet me at Twitch. Alright, so just to let you know, here on the screen are the timelines if you just want to go ahead and jump over directly into the tutorial. You'll be able to see that currently I remove everything that I have for my PS4 controller. Currently, I cannot play Naruto Ninja Storm 4 with a PS4 controller because I went ahead and cleared everything just for the tutorial purposes. Now I'm going to go ahead and teach you two ways to get this to work. You can either use the Xbox 360 emulator, which is the main, I guess, course of this video, but I'm also going to teach you another way how to do it without even using the emulator if you want to go that route. Currently, I have my PS4 controller, which is plugged into a USB cable, and as you can see here right now, it's not even responding at all. Now, this is the website that I use to download the files that I'll be needing, but if you go to the description below, you can find all the URLs which I have uploaded the files that you will be using for this process. Now, the very first step you're going to do is download the Xbox 360 controller emulator that you'll need, either 32-bit or 64-bit. Now, personally, I believe that the majority of people use computers in 64-bit. Now, in my case, I downloaded the Xbox 360 controller emulator in 64-bit. So I'm going to go ahead and load that. And usually this file is going to be zip. After you have extracted this file, you'll notice that you have Xbox 360 or x360ce, which is controller emulator, _x64.exe. So the next step you want to do here is select that file and go ahead and copy it. Now, after you have copied the exe, we're going to go ahead and go back to our Steam and find out the game that we're looking for. Just find the game folder directory for that. In this case, in Steam, just go ahead and click on properties. After clicking properties, you will go to local files and browse local files, and this will load wherever that game is loaded into your computer. Now, right off the bat, as you can see, we currently have the Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4.exe file, which is what you'll be using to run or execute the game. In this case, I'm going to right click and paste my Xbox 360 emulator, and right away just go ahead and run it. Now, when I double click on the exe file, you'll notice that it will load the emulator. The first thing that it asks me or tells me is that there is no Xinput DLL file. This is the main file that you need to be able to translate whatever configuration you have from your controller into the game that you're running. In this case, since we don't have any DLL file for the Xinput, we're going to go ahead and click on create. So that will load a brand new blank Xinput1_3.dll. Now, this is the default file. After you do that, it's going to ask you what is the configuration that you have for your game controller. And the good thing about doing it through the download from the search on the internet is that when you click on next, he knows where you're located, which is in the Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm folder. So he would preload a default setting found in the internet for that particular game. In this case, after that is loaded, go ahead and click on finish. And as soon as you do that, you will be able to hear that beep. That beep means that he detected the PS4 controller, and now you can test it out to see how it looks in your emulator. So I'm going to go ahead and take my PS4 controller, and as soon as I have any input from the PS4 controller, you'll notice that all the triggers are being pressed and they are loaded into the emulator. Click on save and close it. And pretty much that's it. Now, there's a little trick to this. after you have uploaded and you have installed the emulator and you have the DLL file loaded there, you want to test out to see if the game runs. Now, in this case, I can go ahead and close and load our game. In this case, I'm going to be using the Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4.exe file, which is executable for that game. You can either double click this here or you can load it from Steam. Now the game is loading, and as soon as you see, I'll be able to press the PS4 controller buttons, but nothing is actually happening. As you can see, I can press anything here and the game is not responding. And the reason why is because currently the DLL that I have installed is not a compatible one for my computer. And this is the part where it's very important for you to go ahead and change the DLL file name to the one that works for you. Now, this part is actually trial and error. There's no specific formula to determine which is the DLL file that works for you. So you would have to go through the list of the 5 different DLL file names to be able to get this to work. Now you can check the description below and check out to see the 5 different names that you could use for your DLL file. In my case, I already know which is the Xinput file name that I need to use for my computer to work. In this case, the default one is xinput1_3.dll. I'm just going to go ahead and right click and change the name by clicking on rename. In my case, I know that the Xinput name that I need is xinput9_1_0.dll. As soon as I do that, I'm going to go ahead and run the Naruto game one more time. And this time, I want you to listen to that little beep that just went through. That means that it detected the PS4 controller as if it was an X input. So now, my inputs from my PS4 controller will be translated into an Xbox 360 controller input. Now, just to let you know, because I didn't want to make this video too long and I wanted to make it short and effective, I went ahead and created a new video for how to use your PS4 controller on Steam without using the Xbox 360 emulator. You can check that out in the card up here. So I hope this video has been helpful for you guys. Please let me know in the comments below if you have any other doubts or questions. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to click on the notification bell so that you can be notified every single time I release a new video. This was Eddie04. See you on the next one. Yeah.